Dear students, it's nice to talk to you this afternoon. We are in a very, very difficult situation, and I'm sure all of you are waiting to come to school, and we as teachers are also missing you very much. And it's now we realize that it was you who had brought that cheer and that happiness in our lives. The school is deserted, the classrooms are empty, and we really miss you so much. We miss your mischief, we miss your play, we miss your beaming faces and the smiles on your face. So all this has brought a lot of meaning to us, and dear children, we miss you so much. But still, these are difficult times, and we have to make the best use of the time. So what should we do? First and foremost, we should get into the mode of learning. The moment we stop learning, do you know, we stop living and we start dying. It is very dangerous. It is learning which brings some kind of purpose in our life. Learning widens your horizons. Research says that while learning even changes the neural network in your mind. So learning is very, very vital for you. Learning will give you confidence, it will give you competence, and it will give you courage, and that will take you forward. So my dear students, never compromise on learning. It's important for you to hone your skills. You're all very talented, you're all very skilled, you're all highly potential kids. Now it's very important for you to nurture these skills. I was recently talking to a young man who was doing his BTech in robotics. You know what he told me? He told me that he had set a target to complete 10 online courses. And he said already he's through with 8 courses. And it's all from international universities, and it'll be certified courses. So you see, there are a lot of opportunities today. And incidentally, that boy is living in a village today. So opportunities are available. I request all of you to get into the learning mode. That's number one. Number two, the most important thing is to find the ikigai of your life. Ikigai is a Japanese word, which means finding purpose for your life. It is the ikigai which makes you to spring out from your bed each and every day. And that really gives you a meaning, a purpose. For example, for Ruskin Bond, even at a very early stage, as a young man, he found out that writing was his ikigai. And he pursued after it. And today, he is a very phenomenal writer who appeals to youngsters, who appeals to children. So my dear students, you have to find out your ikigai. Jane Goodall, for her, chimpanzees was her ikigai. For Salim Ali, birds was his ikigai. For Ramanujam, mathematics was his ikigai. So what is the ikigai of your life? There was a small boy who was studying in 8th standard, and one day his science teacher came and explained about heart. She drew a wonderful diagram on the blackboard. This boy was inspired, and that day he found out his ikigai. He found out the mission for his life. And that was Devi Shetty. Today, he is a very popular heart surgeon. Find out your ikigai in your life, and you will not keep quiet, and you will start learning. So that is very, very important. The third aspect is that you will have to fall in rhythm with nature. You know what it is said about Isaac Newton? It is said, nature and nature's laws lay hid in night. God said, let Newton be. And all was light. Nature had impacted him, and Isaac Newton studied it so closely, and he was able to unravel the mysteries of nature. And today he has left a legacy. So be in rhythm with nature. Most of you are in villages and you are close with nature. Take a walk with your parents, work in the fields, observe the birds, observe the butterflies, observe the flowers, and I'm sure nature is going to be a great teacher for you, provided you are open, you are sensitive, and you are ready to learn. So, my dear students, I request all of you that you would fall in love with nature and you learn from nature. The final thing is that you have to be fit. It's important for you to get up early and sleep only as much as you require to sleep, and follow a schedule, be disciplined, and keep yourself fit. Play for some time and don't get glued to the TV or to the gadgets. It's all right to use gadgets to the minimum, but ensure that this time it becomes very profitable for you and make your life very, very purposeful. And definitely, I'm sure our teachers are reaching out to you through online mode of teaching. This is something new. Certainly, it is not going to replace the teachers in the class, and you will never be able to get that kind of an experience. But still, this is the best alternative, and this is the new normal. So wish you all the best, my dear children. Stay happy with your parents, and work with your mom in the kitchen, and talk to your grandparents, and spend time with them, and live happily. I'm sure you will have a wonderful time. So God bless you. You have a lot of talents. I conclude with a quote from Shakespeare. You know what Shakespeare says? Man, what a piece of work is man. How noble in reason, how infinite in faculty, in form and moving, how express and admirable, in action, how like an angel, in apprehension, how like a god. The beauty of this world, the paragon of virtues. This is your potential. This is your skill. I only wish that you will put them into use. No, nothing on this earth can really break the human spirit. No cell, no shackles, no prison can thwart you. Remember, Nelson Mandela was in the prison for 27 years, but he never lost his vision for his country. He never lost his thirst and his ikigai that was to get the freedom for his countrymen and to fight apartheid. So my dear students, all the best to you, and make the best use of this time. Thank you so much.